Students, in this class we will be doing class 9 triangles chapter. We are doing exercise 7.1. Few sums we have completed already. Remaining sums I will be completing in this exercise. AC is equal to AE. These two line segments are equal. And AB is equal to AD. And BAD, this angle, is equal to angle EAC. These two angles are equal. Show that BC is equal to DE. Since we are asked to say that BC is equal to DE, we will take that triangle. So in triangle BAC and triangle DAE. So these two triangles we will take. So if you take this triangle BAC, so this angle of triangle ABC and this AD of the triangle is same, that is given in the question. So AB is equal to AD. So this AD, it is given in the question that AB is equal to AD and AC is equal to AE. Now we are taking this triangle. I am taking this triangle and then this triangle. So these two triangles I am taking. So when you take this bigger triangle, you will get this angle. For this triangle, this side is there, AC. AB is there. For this triangle, AD is there. So that is given in the question. Same way, the other side also. That is AC. AC of triangle BAC. AC is equal to AE. AC is equal to AE. That is also given in the question. Okay, then one more thing is given. This angle. This angle and this angle are only given as equal. But we have taken the triangle BAC and DAE. So in this smaller part is common to both. So that part, that angle DAC, that angle I am adding with this A. In the question it is given these two angles are equal, that is angle BAD and angle CAE. Those two angles are equal, it is given. Now I am adding angle DAC to both the angles. I am adding angle DAC to both the sides. So this angle and this angle will be equal. Understood? So this part, this smaller part is common to both. So I am adding it with that. I will get the bigger angle, that is BAC and DAE. Those two angles I will get. So that I will write angle BAD is equal to angle EAC. This is only given in the question. I am adding angle for with this angle BAD, I am angle DAC. On both the angles, I am adding this angle DAC. So if I add this angle with BAD with DAC, I will get BAC. Angle BAC I will get. Same way for the other one, EAC and DAC will become angle EAD. Angle EAD. Understood? So one angle and two sides. So these two sides for the both the triangles and these two angles. So by SAS controversy, two sides and one angle, triangle BAC is congruent to triangle DAE. By SAS congruence. Okay, clear? So since we have proved this, both the triangles SA are congruent, by CPCT we can say that BC is equal to DE. So till this we have proved the congruency of both the triangles. Then after this we can say that BC is equal to DE by CPCT. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles. By that property, BC is equal to DE. That is the thing we are asked to prove. Seventh sub. AB is a line segment. AB is a line segment and P is its midpoint. D and E are the points on the same side of AB. That is above and below. It's there. So E and D are on the same side. Okay. Are points on the same side of AB such that angle BAD, angle BAD, this angle BAD is equal to angle ABE. These two angles are equal. And EPA, EPA, this angle, and DPB, these two angles are equal. Show that triangle DAP, DAP, angle DAP, so triangle DAP is congruent to triangle EBP, EBP. So this triangle and this triangle are congruent, you have to say. Okay, since P is the midpoint, so we will take this triangle DAP in triangle DAP and triangle EBP. So if you take these two triangles, if you take, in that it is given, in the question itself it is given BAD, BAD, angle BAD is equal to angle ABE. So one set of angles are, one pair of angles are equal. That is given in the question. Then, since P is the midpoint, we can say that AP is equal to PB. Since P is the midpoint, these two are equal. AP is equal to BP or AP is equal to PB. These two length or measurement of these two length are equal. Then, if you are asked to find, DAP, this full triangle and this full triangle, in the question it is given, this part of angle is equal. But we need this full angle. So, for telling that, if we add this angle EPD to both the sides, EPD to both the sides. So, if you add this part to this side, this will become, already these two angles are equal. This angle is called, this commonly we are going to add for these two angles. So, this angle will be equal and this angle will also be equal. So, that we are going to see. Okay, so EPA, angle EPA is equal to angle DPB. EPA is equal to angle DPB. Now, in this angle EPA, I am going to add EPD plus angle EPD. So, this EPD I am going to add for both the angles. Angle EPD, these two angles I am going to add. So, if I add EPA and EPD, what angle I will get? I will get angle APD. Angle APD is equal to angle DPB plus angle EPD. So, this part of angle and this part of the angle, if I add, I will get angle EPB. So, this is equal and true. So, two angles and one side is equal. So, by ASA congruency, the triangle DAP, is congruent to triangle EBP. So, then one more thing they are asked to say, AD is equal to BE. AD is equal to BE. So, since that is the corresponding parts of the two congruent triangles, we have proved the congruency. Then by CPCT, we can say that AD is equal to BE. This is by CPCT. So, we have given the proof for both the things. Okay. 8th sir. In triangle ABC, so ABC is a triangle right angled at C. So you are having right angle at C. So this is a right angle triangle. M is the midpoint of hypotenuse AB. So AB is the hypotenuse and M is the midpoint of the hypotenuse. C is joined to M. C is joined to M and produced to a point D. C is joined to M and produced to a point D such that DM, such that DM is equal to CM, such that DM is equal to CM. Point D is joined. Point D is joined to point B. Show that triangle AMC, this triangle is congruent to triangle BMD. So these two triangles are congruent. This is the first thing you have to prove. Then angle DBC is a right triangle. This one DBC is a right angle. Angle DBC is a right angle. And triangle DBC. So this full triangle is congruent to triangle ACB. And fourth one, CM is equal to half of AB. So these are the things you are asked to prove. Okay, so first one is AMC. So we will take triangle AMC. So in triangle AMC and triangle BMD. So these two triangles first we will take. So in these two triangles it is given that CM is equal to DM. That is given in the question. So CM is equal to DM. So this is given in the question. And AMC. So if you have two intersecting lines, these two angles will be vertically opposite angles. So these two will be vertically opposite angles. So that is angle AMC. Angle AMC is equal to angle BMD. Angle BMD. So this is vertically opposite angles. So these two angles and these two sides are equal. And then M is the midpoint of the hypotenuse AB. So M is the midpoint of AB. So AM is equal to BM. Since M is the midpoint. It is given in the question that M is the midpoint. Since it is midpoint, AM is equal to BM. So these two are also equal. So by SAS congruence, both the triangles are congruent. That is triangle AMC is equal to, is congruent. Triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD. So this is by SAS. SAS is side angle set. So these two sides and one angle. So the first thing we have proved. Proof, we have to prove angle DBC is a right angle. That is this angle we have to say that it is 90 degree. So for proving that, already we have proved that these two triangles are congruent. So since these two triangles are congruent, we can take that these two angles are equal. That is, since we have proved that congruency of both the triangles, by CBSE we can say that angle AMC is equal to MAC. Angle MAC. This angle MAC is equal to angle MBD. So this is by CBSE. By CBSE we can say that MAC and MBD are equal. So those two angles form alternate angles. Those two angles form alternate angles of these two lines. So since they are alternate angles, and it is equal, we can say that AC is equal to D, is parallel to DB. Since these form, these angles that we have proved that it is equal, forms alternate angles, we can say that these two, since alternate angles are equal, we can say that these two lines are parallel. Since by proved above, we can say that AC, we can say that AC is parallel to DB. AC is parallel to DB. Since alternate angles are equal. What are alternate angles? Just now we have proved that these two are alternate angles. So since those angles are equal, they forms the alternate angle part of two lines. The other two lines, the lines enclosed by those two angles will be parallel. That is AC parallel to DB. Since they are parallel, these two lines are parallel. Already we know that this angle is 90 degree. So these two angles form co-interior angles. This angle and this angle forms co-interior angles of parallel lines. That is angle ACB plus angle ABC is equal to 180 degree. That is co-interior angles. Co-interior angles. They are the co-interior angles. So co-interior angles are supplementary for any two parallel lines. So ACB, in the question itself it is given that 90 degree. So ABC is equal to 180 minus 90. So that forms 90 degree. So which is 90 degree here? Angle A, ACB, and here this is DBC. Sorry, this is not ABC, this is DBC. Angle DBC. So that only we are asked to prove that DBC, angle BC here, angle DBC forms 90 degree. So this is the second proof. Then third one is triangle DBC. Triangle DBC is congruent to triangle ACB. Third proof is triangle DBC in triangle DBC. That is the congruency you are asked to prove. So in triangle DBC and triangle ACB. So DBC is this right angle triangle and ACB is that right angle triangle. So for that one, just now we have proved that DBC, angle DBC is equal to angle ACB, that is 90 degree. Both forms 90 degree. These two angles are equal, that we have proved. Then DBC is equal to ACB, that we have proved that it is 90 degree. Okay, then next one is BC is equal to BC. So that is common. So this part is common to both. So BC is equal to BC. So this is common. So this part of the thing is common. Then already these two angles, these two triangles, we have proved that it is CPCT. So AC is equal to DB. So AC is equal to, sorry, that is that side of triangle. So we have to write this side only. So DB is equal to AC. So this is by CPCT. So here two sides and one angle, we have proved that they are equal. So triangle DBC is congruent to triangle ACB by two sides and one angle. So by SAS congruence, both the triangles are congruent. The last proof, fourth one, CM is equal to half AB. Just now we have proved the congruency of DBC and ACB. These two triangles are congruent, we have proved. So by CPCT, we can say that DC is equal to AB. DC is equal to AB. This is by CPCT. DC is equal to AB. Okay. So, this DC, you can say that 2CF. This point M. So, this CD, DC, this DC, we can say that 2 times of CM. So, 2CM is equal to AB. So, CM is equal to 1 by 2 AB. CM is equal to 1 by 2 AB. How it is this is, see in the question it is given, M is the point. C is joined to M and produced to a point D such that DM is equal to CM. So, this M is the midpoint for these two, for AB and also for CD. So, this M is the midpoint for both these lines. So, those two lines we have proved that it is equal. So, we can say that CM is equal to half of AB. So, with this, I have completed exercise 7.1 in triangles chapter. In the next class, I will be doing the remaining sums. All the remaining exercises I will do. All these sums, if you do lot of practice only, you can able to understand. So, whatever doubts you have, you post it in the comment box. Please practice. Do lot of practice. Okay, thank you.